Hello students, now today we start our English grammar. We complete our sentences topic. Now we go to the subject and predicate. As I told you previously that a sentence is two parts, subject and a predicate. Now subject is a doer, it is what and who sentence is about, to whom we tells us about, and predicate tells us more about the subject. So here there is exercise. Now circle the subject in the following sentence. Now first one is have done for you, that these chairs are borrowed for the neighbor's house. Here these chairs are the subject of that sentence and are borrowed from the neighbor's house are the predicate. Now we have to circle the subject of that sentences. Now the second one is, the staff has a meeting with the school inspector. So you have to circle that sentence, that part of sentence. This is the subject of the sentence. So you have to done like that all the sentences. Now go to the next question. Underline the subject complement in the following sentence. Means we have to write the predicate. Now Mohini is a happy girl. The one is done for you. Second, the bodybuilder can lift a car. So what the bodybuilder can do? The bodybuilder can lift a car. We have to underline it. Anita was my grandmother's name. So Anita was my grandmother's name. Dr. Kumar has fever. Has fever. The tea is hot. Is hot. Because in all these sentences, happy girl. Who is happy girl? Mohini. Who can lift a car? The bodybuilder. Whose grandmother's name was Anita? Who has fever? Dr. Kumar. And how is the tea? How is hot? Which is hot? The tea. So that type we have to done this. Now next, there are the kinds of sentences. You have already read it in the previous class. There are the sentences can be divided into four kinds, declarative sentence or assertive sentence. Second is interrogative sentence, imperative sentence, and exclamatory sentence. The sentence that express the facts, action, and happenings are called as declarative or assertive sentence. The sentence which have questions, WH words or the helping words or the auxiliary words. So these types of sentences are called interrogative sentence, where some questions being you asked. Third one is imperative sentence, where request, command, suggestions, advice can be expressed. Those sentences are called as imperative sentence. Now the fourth one is exclamatory sentence. They express sudden feeling, emotions such as joy, sorrow, surprise, anger, delight. These sentences are called as exclamatory sentence. Now here, you look here, like the question first is, insert the correct punctuation mark and at the end of the sentence, write the sentence type for each in the given space. Now first one is done for you, like hello. My name is Diya. So hello, my name is Diya. This one is which type of sentence? Declarative. That is wonderful news. This sentence express an feeling. This one is exclamatory sentence. You have to put the exclamation sign here. Yes, I will do this work. This one is imperative sentence. Yes, has he returned? So there is a question. So you put the question mark and write interrogative sentence. Could you switch on the lights? This one is express the command. So this one is imperative sentence. Now wow, I like this. This one is exclamation sign. So this one is exclamatory sentence. Now here, I have given you 5 sentences, so this one is your homework to write the sentence with their punctuation and write which type of sentence is this. This one is also same type of question. You have to do this. Okay. Now go to the next one. This one is change the following assertive sentence into negative. So in this sentence, what you have to do that in every helping verb, you put the not. After helping verb, you put not and make the sentence negative. Like Oliver Twist is a wonderful book. So when you make it negative, you write it, Oliver Twist is not a wonderful book. So that type you have to complete this exercise. And now in this page, same question. In first lesson, in first page, I have already told you about how to arrange these words and to make a meaningful sentence. You have to write the correct structure of that tense. Subject plus auxiliary verb plus main verb plus helping verb. So like that you have to done it. Okay, students. So your homework is to complete our exercise. And next I will tell you about the contraction form of the words. Thank you.